Hi Leo, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love lives or your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Leo, it's quite a dynamic month. We have two planets that are in action this month. We have Mercury that is retrograde the entire month till about 23rd of December. And then we have the mighty planet Saturn that is moving its sign. It's going to be doing its next 2.5 year circuit. On the 3rd, we have a full moon that is there in your house of friendships, groups of people, people who share similar goals, similar ambitions as you do. And full moon over here is, full moon is all about fruition. It's about completion. It could be that some of you could just be taking a long distance trip with some of your friends, or maybe a group of people who subscribe or are as passionate as you are about. It could be a hobby club, it could be just a group of you who are working towards a similar goal. And for some of you, it could mean that it's really something which is coming to a full circle. Maybe you don't need certain friends, or you've outgrown them, or you've outgrown maybe partying a lot, or maybe generally hanging around with a lot of people who otherwise are not really adding value to your life. So it's an acceptance, it's a realization, it's a slight shift that you'll feel. You'll be letting go, and this could have happened over a period of last say couple of months. It's nothing that's drastic that'll happen. On the 4th, we have Mercury that goes retrograde till about 23rd, and it's going retrograde in your house of love, relationships, children and creativity. It's a time, and because it's happening towards end of the year, and there's been a lot of focus, Leos, for especially for those of you who have your sun, moon and rising in Leo, focus being there on your relationships and also on your creativity. And now with towards end of the year, it's a time to be reflecting. It's a time to look at things that worked, that didn't work, as far as your relationships are concerned, as far as maybe dealing with your children that is concerned, or even as far as creativity is concerned. Maybe some of you could have thought that a specific project or a job or a creative endeavor could work quite well for you, and you would have realized that over a period of year that it's not something that you are too happy doing it. For some of you, it could be the opposite. It could be that this year, 2017, was a year where you really found your passion, where you really started enjoying doing something, you found your calling. So it's a time to be reflecting on, you know, the meaning of what creativity means to you, your relationship with your children, how it is that you let out the child in yourself out, and how it is also that you treat yourself with a lot of love or with a lot of criticism. So it's a time to be rethinking, it's a time to be revising, it's time to be retweaking all the lessons that have been learned in 2017 as far as love and relationships are concerned. On the 10th, we have Mars that is moving to Scorpio, and it is joining Jupiter that is there in your house of home. This is the house which is ruled by Cancer. It's the house of your mother. And again, this house too has been lit up for you the entire 2017. And with Mars coming over here, you can expect that either some of you could be expanding your house, there could be some renovation, you could be moving to a larger house, you may have friends coming and staying with you. There could be a lot of house guests during this time. It can also be it also involves a lot of times renting, leasing and buying of property as well. On the 18th, we have a new moon that is there in your house of creativity and love and romance and children. And it's a wonderful time to be having a dialogue, Leos. It's a great time to be going out and spending some time with your loved ones. And for those of you, if things have been slightly challenging, it's a wonderful time to be opening a dialogue. Air your thoughts out and rather than be in a space where you feel rejected, or you feel that what you're seeing is absolutely not being accepted, or you're not being accepted, or that your reality is not being validated, use the new moon energy to start afresh, to look at from a fresher perspective, to try and look at things maybe you have been battling with for the longest of time and there's been no answer, no solution over here. On the 20th, we have Saturn, the mighty, mighty Saturn, and he is moving houses, and he's moving from Sagittarius to Capricorn, where we have Pluto, and Pluto has been there for the last couple of years in Capricorn, and it carries on being there for the next couple of years as well in Capricorn. Now, the Saturn and Pluto energy, it's quite potent, though. I personally feel that even though we call Pluto as the dwarf planet in astrology, the Plutonian energy, I feel it's far more stronger. It's very potent, more potent than a Saturn energy. So Saturn you have, who's a teacher, who will sort of make you go back and redo things. And then you have Pluto, and Pluto is not just happy with your hard work. He'll make you dig deep underneath the surface and see as to what is it that is festering over there. So roots are where you need to strengthen. That is where you really need to be reworking and redoing things. And it is all about restructure. So Pluto is not just happy or satisfied or at ease, even if you are working hard. It wants you to restructure it, go to the bottom of it, or maybe underneath the bottom, and figure out as to what is it, the cause, what are the triggers that are being pressed. And then the Saturnian work begins on top of that. And for you, all this is happening in a house of your day-to-day chores, your health, and your work. So Saturn, of course, will make you roll up your sleeves. That's the best way to work with a Saturn energy, is to work along with it. And Pluto along with it, you need to be digging deeply and seeing why is it that a certain health situation has not moved for you. Why is it that you're still sort of going round and round with a certain work situation as well? Or even on managing of a day-to-day chores, which may seem very mundane, but you're not sort of able to manage it, or there is no smoothness, or there's been a constant chaos, or something that could be bothering. So Saturn is saying more structure, more hard work. Pluto is saying restructure. It's saying go underneath, below it, and figure out as to what the solution lies. On the 22nd, we have Sun that comes and lights up your house of day-to-day chores and your health. And Sun over here is going to be giving you an opportunity again, and it's encouraging you. Maybe for some of you, you could find a great trainer to work with, or you could just simply find a holistic way of working out which your body responds wonderfully well. For some of you, it could be that a work situation, maybe you've been battling it for the longest and you find a wonderful solution now with it. Use the new moon energy to make it more solution based. Look at, explore those opportunities that are there, because there seem to be these tiny windows that are opening around you as far as these issues are concerned, Leo. So don't hesitate, or even think that, you know, I think it's a very small temporary thing, or maybe it's not worth trying, or maybe it's not as big as it should be. Explore the small windows that are there. They may just lead you to the main door, which will allow you to sort of get inside and sort out this stuff. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Leos. I'll see you again soon, and thank you so much for watching.